been the biggest surprise for you about the Nashville audience so far?
The biggest what?
Surprise of the Nashville audience so far.
The biggest surprise. Well, you know, my biggest surprise is that I wish there were more. I mean, I thought there would be more. I mean, because I think that the show is unique,
yeah,
you know, right now in the landscape, and it's a world that hasn't been explored, at least not in this way. And so, I mean, I'm glad that the people I've run into, people who love the show, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really great, because when you're in the sausage factory, you kind of don't really, you're like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
But so that I guess the biggest surprise then is A, not more, and B, I'm amazed that the people who love the show love it with the fervor that they do.
Yeah. It's been a weird fall for launching shows, so it's good that you guys have managed to stick around, and I enjoy it. It's fun.
It's fun.
Yeah. Well, there are some really intense coupling so far. You know, we just saw at the end of the last episode, Scarlett and Gunnar took a step, but they've been dancing around for months. So why did you guys decide to kind of play that card so soon?
You know what? I mean, because it had to be played, and then you had to deal with the consequences of it, and the reality of, you know, it's sort of like the fantasy you can only sustain for so long.
Yeah.
And it was more interesting to see, well, now what?
So what can you tease about the what?
Well, what I can say is that if they hadn't had that happen a couple of episodes ago, it might be a very different relationship. But now we're in a place where Gunnar's brother's dead.
Yeah.
He's in a very different emotional place. She's got her own trajectory happening with her, what happens with her career. So that they're very different people now than they were two episodes ago. So how do they stay together given all that?
Should fans be thinking that these two are going to be entering into an actual relationship anytime soon?
I think they're going to try.
But on the other end of the spectrum, Deacon and Raina have so many issues and so many years between them. What can you tell us what's coming up for them now that she's no longer married?
Well, as with life, when you're available, the one you want isn't, right? So I think we're going to be playing with that a little bit. And, you know, she has to look at her life now. I think being married to Teddy for a long time kept her from having to, she didn't have to deal with a lot of those feelings in a way. So now with that obstacle sensibly removed, she has to figure out what her life is, how anybody romantically figures into that.
Will the guilt of keeping his daughter from him start weighing on her more heavily now that she doesn't have that marriage, that stability to kind of occupy her?
Yeah, I mean, you know, how it's a level of dishonesty that she's had to live with for a while.
Well, they were together.
And if there's any future with him, it would certainly kind of require honesty, one would think.
What's going to happen?
And what's coming up for Juliet? Okay. Her mother drama seems to be at a full level.
Well, her mom continues to be a presence in her life, but now that she's fired her manager and tried to take charge of her own empire with mixed results, as one might imagine, I think she is going to continue to be successful musically, but, you know, how meaningful is that in your life if the rest of your life is cuckoo-verse, right? So she's got her struggles.
Is she going to have any significant love interest coming up?
Always.
Anyone you can tease?
Really?
Is there anyone that is already on the canvas?
Well, I think that anybody, if you're looking at the show and you put a really attractive male in the scene with Juliet, you might guess that something could happen there. So I would say that it would not be a big stretch to think that there might be something with her mom somewhere.